Hello, welcome to Cimbrer Bushcraft. It's a quiet day today, and actually I wanted to make a video with no talk, but as the title indicates, I have something to tell you and something to ask about. My Seax, this one, you saw I made a sheet for it, a very simple leather sheet, and there's two reasons for that. The first reason is that a Seax shall always be kept in the sheet with the sharp end or the edge upwards, so it doesn't hurt the sheet when you go into it. So my sheet that I got from the knife maker that make my Seax didn't do that. The sharp side of the knife is turning down, and every time I'm putting it down in my sheet, it will eventually cut through it. So I made a new sheet, and I actually have made a little video about that. And if you'd like to see that, you can see it here. First, I have cut a piece of leather in a rectangular shape, and then I sand it because I like the surface matte and not glossy. Then I'm finished. I'm trying the Seax, how it fits. And you can see there's plenty of leather that I can cut off later. Then I find out I have to make markings. I think it was 4.5 centimeters on both sides. And better to make it a little bit bigger, because you can always fit the knife in and the glue will expand. You'll see that later. And after marking these two sides, I apply some glue. It's contact glue, so it has to dry up a bit before I assemble it. And of course I'm doing that on both sides. So after a couple of minutes, it is dry and I can put it together. And it has to be under pressure for some time. But first I have to see if the Seax can go in there. It's a tight fit, and it should be a tight fit. Yeah, that looks very nicely. Then I put these on and some clamps to secure it when it's drying. You see, yeah. Then when it's dry, I take them off, and again check if the Seax is still a nice fit, and then I have to cut the length of the sheath. And I measure it here, make the markings, and then I have to consider I have to sew it together, so I'll cut it a little bit wider from that marking. Yeah. Then I put in the Seax again. Remember, it's going to be pointing upwards. Fits the right size, so then I can move on. And I made the template that I can use where I'm going to attach the belt straps on, and then I just mark them.
And there's going to be two on this sheath. And here you can see my two points where I'm going to attach my belt loop. Then I make the holes where I'm going to make the stitching. All the way down. And of course up there where my belt straps are going to be. Just be patient, be careful not to make a wrong turn with that hole, and you're good. Yeah, here you can see it's going to be. And now the other one. And then I have to cut it out, and that's a little bit difficult because there are rounded edges. The first part is easy, I can use a ruler, but then I have to cut it out like this, and it's a little bit difficult. But just work slowly, cut it a little bit at a time, and then at the end you will succeed, and the final shape of the sheet is done. Yeah. Then after rounded the edges, you can see I cut the holes out in the middle with a little sharp knife. And finally, I have the two holes that I'm going to put the straps in. Yeah, looks fine. Then I have to dye the leather with some leather color, and I use golden brown. And I apply it a couple of times. And then I begin the sewing of the sheath. And again, I use wax linen thread and double stitching. And it's very easy whether one needle comes out, the other one goes in. Just tighten it. Yeah, you can see a good beginning. Then you just have to continue down the sheath until you're finished with that. And then, yeah, it looks good, I think. Yeah, then I have to make these stitching. And this is how it looks when it's finished. Then I take my Seax and wrap it in some plastic foil. Plastic wrappings you normally use for food and so on. And that's because I want to protect the knife from moisture, because I'm going to wet mold it. And also the knife will be a little bit thicker, so so it's easy to come in and out of the sheath. Then I put the sheath down in some water. I let it soak, not completely soak, but I have to be somewhere filled with water, and then you put the seax in, or the knife, yeah, and then it will expand the leather, so the leather will be a little bit whiter there, and then apply a little bit more water here, because where the handle and the blade are joining, I want to wet mold it there, and I use my hands for that. Yeah, and the leather is soft and you can mold it, and when it's dry it will stay in that place. Yeah, then I measure the holes, 1.5 centimeter. Then I have to make the straps. So from the same leather, I cut off two pieces of leather straps, 1.5 centimeter. Again, using a sharp knife. Always use sharp tools. It's more secure. You don't have to put a lot of pressure on it. Then, yeah, tight fit, but it should be a tight fit because later on I'm going to round the edges, so the straps will be a little bit smaller. Using this tool to remove the sharp edges, and the product will look more finished, more professional. And I do that on both sides. And of course, yeah, I sandpaper it again so that it won't be glossy but matte. Then apply some leather color. Again, I use the same golden brown. And the one, the small strap is 20 centimeters, I think, and the long one is 30. So it makes the one in front 10 centimeters high and the other 15 centimeters. Yeah. Then I have to put them together, and for that I use glue again. Contact glue. Glue on both sides. Then put pressure on for about 10 minutes until it's dry. It's important that they are aligned so that they don't they have a straight line. Then I chose to sew it together, only letting the upper part be free for the belts. And this can be done in many ways, but I choose to make it in this way, a little zigzag. And using the same thread, wax linen, and the double stitching. Yeah. This is the final result. Then see if the Seax fits. Yeah, looking good. And the sharp end of the knife is upwards. Then I use some sandpaper again. And why? Yeah, because I want it to look old. I don't like shiny new things, so I try to make it look like an old worn out sheath. I like that. And looks very cool when I sanded it, I think. Yeah, you see scratches in it. Unfortunately, when I apply some leather fat, it will most of it will not be seen there. Then, yeah, I made some ornaments, some Viking ornaments with my laser picker, my laser engraver. And then I apply the leather fat and let that soak in. Yeah, and this is the final result. My little sheet for my Seax. I hope you like it. It's a fun little project and I think it's a easy project too.
Yeah, I hope you enjoyed this little video. As I said in the video, it's very simple. Way to make a sheet on, but it's working, it's fine, and I like the design of this. I haven't heard from the knife maker, so now I'm going to see if anyone out there would be interested in making such a Seax, a knife for me, a Viking Seax or a Cimbrer Seax. So anyone who's interested in that, and I would prefer if it was someone here in Europe that was interested in that. I had a lot of response from my viewers that saying they want to buy this knife or this Seax, so I think it will be something you could profit from, and you could probably sell a few of them. And some of my subscribers has also mentioned that they love my sheath, and it's really cool and it's beautiful. But I think it's very expensive to make. So if you want to make two kind of sheath, the one with the brass on and something simple like mine that I made here. Doesn't has to be exactly like this, but something you can put on your belt and wear it horizontal as I do. So if you are interested in making a collaboration with me, please make a note in my comment sections or send me an email. I'm very excited to hear from you out there. I think it could be a good collaboration with Cimbrer Bushcraft. So I hope I get some. Yeah. And did you notice my new coat from Grimfrost? Yeah. I got an email from them that they were going to sell these, and I ordered one immediately. I think it's so cool and so nice. The only drawback is it is in made from wool, so it's a little bit heavy here in the summer, but today it's not that hot, so I can have it on, and I think it's looking very cool too. Yeah, Grimfrost makes a lot of nice products, I can tell you, and I have a link in my video description, so if you're using that, you're supporting me. Yeah, well, it's a wonderful day out here, and it's actually a new place near the dark forest where I usually come, but this is a new area here, and it is really cool. I will make some footage so we can see the surroundings here, and it will be a very nice place for an overnighter that I will hopefully be doing soon out here. Yeah. Martin is very busy at the moment, so I haven't been able to make something together with him. And beside that, there's been a lot of bad weather, rain all the time. This is actually the first day that the sun is shining, and the next few days it will be almost like summer, over 20 degrees Celsius. So I'm looking forward to that. And as you also saw, I made a new meal today, a new dish. Viking Burger. It was very delicious, and my flatbread is actually tasting very nice together with the meat there, the beef. Yeah, and a little bit of onion and some cucumber, I think it's called. Yeah, a little bit dressing. I like dressing. I'm glad you joined me today. I hope you're enjoying this wonderful day together with me. You can probably hear the birds singing. Yeah. And a few minutes ago, I heard a raven too. It's a really cool place here. I think I'll show you the surroundings here, so you can see what it is I'm looking at. And look what I also found. I found a new website called Vehi Mercatus. I put a link in my video description so you can find it. They have a lot of cool stuff. And this little birch bark container, I have some nuts in, so I can eat here when I'm out. Doing my little Viking hikes. Very delicious. Very well made. Yeah, and they are fast. It's a German company, and they have a good service. Check them out if you want. Yeah, and I got a new thing for one of my wonderful subscriber, Scotty, or scottcetnar from Albany in the US. Yeah, it's a salve. He's making himself. He called it the Piney Pitch Salve, and it has a lot of good stuff in it. Pure cold press olive oil, avocado oil, pine pitch resin, hemp seed oil, Texas bee wax, and frankincense resin. Yeah, and he sent me a couple of these, one for my wife and me, and it's really awesome. It's a good salve. You can use it almost anything. If you have wounds in your hands or dry hands, dry skin, you can use it for that. Hundreds of different ways you can use this. It's a product that was used by the native Indians in America, I think he's told me. And yeah, I'm very grateful for that. Dry, cracked hands, sore muscles, joints, cuts, scrapes, bug bites, and so on. It's really cool, and he's actually selling these. So in my video description, I'll put his email address so you can contact him if you are interested in this salve. I don't know the price of this, but you can ask him. And I can definitely recommend you this. I used it for some of my cuts I got when I was carving my bowl, and it actually works very nicely. So, Scotty, thank you very much, and I hope that some of you could be interested in this and perhaps buy a few of those from Scotty. Yeah, this is all for now, folks. I hope you enjoyed this little video on my DIY project, my little sheath for my Seax. Yeah, it was a wonderful day, and I'm glad you joined me here in this magical forest. And yeah, I'll be back here for sure. I think I'm going to make an overnighter here if the weather is good. Yeah, so thank you again for watching. Hope to see you again on the next one. Bye bye and take care.